This video will discuss the hormonal regulation of male reproduction. Let's start with what you are already familiar with. That is the hypothalamus and the synthesis and secretion of gonadotropin-releasing hormone, GnRH. Once secreted, gonadotropin-releasing hormone will bind to receptors on the anterior pituitary, causing the endocrine cells to synthesize and secrete both FSH and LH. FSH stands for follicle stimulating hormone. And LH, remember, is luteinizing hormone. LH, as we discussed in previous videos, will stimulate the Leydig cells of the testes to synthesize and secrete testosterone. Testosterone will then enter the plasma and cause target cell responses. Let's review those responses. Testosterone will target skeletal muscle, causing protein synthesis. Testosterone will target the brain to increase sex drive. It will also target the Sertoli cells to stimulate spermatogenesis. Testosterone will promote the development of secondary sex characteristics and the maintenance of those characteristics. Here are a couple of other responses that we have not yet talked about. Testosterone will stimulate growth hormone, GH, secretion, which will stimulate bone growth during adolescence. And finally, testosterone will stimulate the Wolfian ducts to promote development of male reproductive structures during embryonic life. Now let's turn our attention to FSH. Like LH, FSH will bind to receptors on the Sertoli cells to stimulate spermatogenesis, as well as the synthesis and secretion of a protein hormone called inhibin. Since we are talking about inhibin, this is a good time to talk about how to shut down the system. You are already familiar with negative feedback using testosterone. Remember, testosterone will bind to receptors on the hypothalamus and the anterior pituitary. This will shut off the synthesis and secretion of gonadotropin-releasing hormone and luteinizing hormone. Inhibin will bind to the anterior pituitary and shut off the synthesis and secretion of FSH. To sum it all up, negative feedback shuts off the synthesis and secretion of gonadotropin-releasing hormone, luteinizing hormone, and follicle-stimulating hormone, which will all lead to the decrease in the synthesis and secretion of testosterone.